Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you 10 things that you may not know you can do in Safari on the Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So first, did you know you could reopen tabs that you've accidentally closed? I use this all the time. So for instance, let's say I close this tab here. I can instantly undo. If you look at Edit, Undo, it's Undo Close Tab. So a quick Command Z will bring that tab back. But there are other ways to do it as well. You can go to History and then there's Recently Closed and see a list of recently closed tabs. But right under it is Reopen Last Closed Tab, Shift Command T. And if you close the entire window like this, you could bring it back by going to History and then it's Reopen Last Closed Window and all the tabs return. And if you were to quit Safari and then relaunch it and you've got your system preferences set so it opens a fresh new window, not the previous one, you can go to History and use Reopen Last Closed Window there, but also reopen all windows from last session. Now you may know that you can use the Back button. Clicking it will go back to the previous page. But if you click and hold the Back button, you get a list of all of the pages that you've been to. The same is true for the Forward button as well. Now sometimes searching and then finding the web page you want isn't enough. You need to find the information on the web page. So while you're on a page, you can use Command F and it brings up a search box at the top that will search the web page. You can set it to begins with or contains, do a search, and then it'll tell you how many matches and you can flip through each one. It's really handy for finding information buried deep in an article. Now sometimes you want to have a tab or a window open, but you don't necessarily want to have a web page loaded up in it. You could go to Safari, Preferences, and under General, set New Windows to open with empty page or New Tabs to open with empty page. Well, what happens if you want to take the existing tab and just have that display a blank page for the time being? This is a tip that goes back to the very beginning of web browsers in the early 90s. What you need to do is go to the location About : blank. No spaces. That loads up a blank page. An example of when you may use this is say you're about to give a presentation and you know you're going to be showing stuff on the web, so you want to get your browser all set up and ready with the window, the size, and the location that you want, but you don't want it to display anything yet. You can go to About : blank to just display a blank page for the time being. Now when you go to download something from a web page, you can click the download link and it will save that to your downloads folder. But what if you want to save it to a specific location on your drive? You don't want to have to change the location of the downloads folder all the time. Instead, you can control click on the link, two finger click on a trackpad or right click on the mouse, bring up the context menu and use download linked file as. And this allows you to choose a location. You can expand this and choose any location to save this file. So a quick click will save it to your downloads folder, a control click and then download linked file as will save it to the location you want. If you're always doing this and never using the downloads folder, you can go into Preferences and then under General, File Download Location, you could set it to ask for each download. When you want to search for something, you can just type what you want in the address bar here, hit Return, and it will give you search results, usually at Google. But you can change the search engine that's used by default by going to Safari, Preferences, and under Search, and you could set the search engine to one of five different options. And no matter what your default is set to, you don't have to use the address bar to search. You could go directly to the search engine and search using their page. Now when you're at a site, you may want to zoom in by using Zoom In and Zoom Out or the keyboard shortcuts for those. And if you find you're always doing that on a certain website, you can set defaults for that website. Go to Safari, Preferences, Websites, and then look for Page Zoom. Here it'll show me the currently open sites, but even if I don't have the site open, if I've set something different, like I've bumped Wikipedia up to 125%, it will appear in this list. You can change the default right here to whatever you want, and it'll remember that. And you can set the default for all other websites right here. Another thing you could set right here that's really handy is pop-up windows. Select that. It'll show you the current websites and any that you've set something for other than the default. So you can set a specific website to always allow pop-ups. Well, why would you want to do that? Well, I find a lot of websites, particularly financial ones like banks and tax sites and things like that, have downloads tied to pop-up windows. So if you don't allow pop-ups, sometimes downloading from the site doesn't quite work right. Fortunately, those sites usually don't have ads on them of any kind, so allowing pop-ups is pretty harmless and then the site works better. A fairly new feature in Safari is the ability to automatically translate a web page. When you go to a web page that's not in your language, you usually get this little button here that you can click and it will translate for you. Now you can see a lot of the text has been translated, although text and images of course won't be translated. And then as you browse that site, it'll continue to perform the translation until you turn it off. Now I showed you before how you could zoom in on a web page by going to View, Zoom In, and Zoom Out. But if you hold the Option key, this changes to Make Text Bigger, Make Text Smaller. It's like Zoom, but it won't zoom images, only text. So Option Command and then Plus, you can see changes the size of the text, but not the size of the images. In most cases, this is all you really want when you zoom in on a web page. You just want to make the text a little bigger. Now when you're at a web page like this, in the address bar, all you'll see is the domain name. You won't see the actual page you're at. Clearly, we're not at wikipedia.org here. We are at a specific page in Wikipedia. If I click on the address bar, I can see the full location. But I could also see that by default. If I go to Safari, Preferences, and then Advanced, I can select Show Full Website Address, and you can see I'll always see the full address here at the top. You can also navigate in Safari using just the keyboard. You don't have to go to System Preferences and turn on any accessibility function to do that. In Safari Preferences, under Advanced, look at Accessibility here. There's an option here to press Tab to highlight each item on the web page. But note it also says that using Option Tab will give you this functionality without even turning this on. So while I'm here, if I were to normally tab, it would go to places like the Search field here. But if I Option Tab, it actually jumps around to all of the links. And if I want to go to a link, I can just press Return. And then of course in conjunction with other keyboard shortcuts, like under History, the keyboard shortcuts for going back, forward, home, and under File, the ability to go to the address bar to type a new address, Command L, I can navigate pretty much anywhere I want using just the keyboard. Now a lot of times when we want to search for something, we want to actually search for a web page we've already been to. If you do a search here at the top, you can see bookmarks and history here, and it will find a result that's in your history without you having to go to Google or another search engine to find the page again. But you could also go to History, Show All History, and at the top here you can search just your history and find just the pages that you've been to recently. A quick way to do that with the keyboard is use the shortcut Command Y and then do Command F to move to the search field and then just start typing. So there are some things that you might not have known that you can do in Safari on your Mac. Hope you found this useful. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.